No, it's not Wally.
No, guys.
Not mine. Yes, I bet the cheese will come.
How do you mind?
Check, there we go. Good afternoon, everybody. How are you doing today? All right, awesome. My name's Sam. I'm one of the cheetah trainers here at Busch Gardens. Thanks for joining me for our last presentation of the day. And we do have our record holder, fastest cheetah, is going to be running for us here today. So you're in for a treat, yeah. With that being said, anybody know how fast a cheetah can run? Yeah, 70, exactly. 60, 70 miles an hour is what we like to say here. Believe it or not, the cheetah that we're about to see, she was clocked with a radar gun going 64 miles an hour right here on this track. So they're absolutely capable of reaching those same top speeds that they can reach out in Africa. And how we're able to do that is with some equipment that you might have seen some of our other trainers setting up. So if you were here a little bit before 2:30, you might have seen one of our trainers taking a really long green string all the way across the habitat and threading it through a series of pulleys that we have hammered in the ground. Now, Busch Gardens is pretty unique because we have removable pulleys, whereas most other facilities that do cheetah runs have stationary pulleys. So we can change up our track pattern every single day, so the cheetahs really never know what they're going to get when they come out here. Just like how no two hunts in Africa are the same, no two runs here are the same. So that's one of my favorite things about this area. You can watch 100 different cheetah runs. They're all going to be different in some way, shape, or form. If you come back on a different day, you might see a different cheetah running. You might see a different track step as well. Sometimes we do around trees, or do zigzag lightning bolt patterns. So the cheetahs really never know what they're going to get when they come out here. Now, after we thread that string through the pulleys, we're going to tie it together in a loop and wrap it around that machine that you can see on the left-hand side of the habitat. So a pretty simple machine. It's just a battery that connects to a motor that spins a wheel forwards and backwards. So that is how we operate our moving target. So that is what the cheetahs are trying to chase after. They're not chasing after the license over there. They're chasing after that bundle of feathers that she's tying on. So that's what they're chasing after. They're not chasing after their food. That's the biggest difference between a cheetah running at Busch Gardens versus Africa, is that motivation behind the run. So think about it, in Africa, if you don't run, you don't catch your food, you don't get to eat for that day. That's not the case here. They get all their food no matter what. They run because they want to run, not because they have to run to survive. So in Africa, you're running because you're hungry. Here, it's not the case. They get all their food no matter what. Now, they're running because it's more like their fun exercise program. But you do have to teach cheetahs how to run. I know that sounds kind of weird because we always think about speed and running when we think of cheetahs, but they have to learn how to be great runners, and that's true even in Africa. So they're not going to catch that food on the first few hunts that they go on, but they learn what to do, what not to do in order to become a better runner for next time. And we see that same thing here. You do have to teach them how to run. Kind of like showing them that, think about for those of us that have house cats at home, think about that toy. It's kind of like a wand with a string and a feather on the end of it, and your cat chases that around. So think about a giant version of that kind of for the cheetahs. So that's really step one, is teaching them that it's a fun game to chase and catch that moving target. And I'll tell you, if you just show a cheetah a bundle of feathers and they have no learning with that, they're not going to really know what to do with it. So step one is teaching them that's a fun game to chase and catch that moving target. And then after they're chasing it, you can see those feathers in the testing right now. You need to have them catch those feathers from the right the fastest, because whatever they're doing, the second they catch those feathers, that's exactly what they're going to show us again the next time. So if Faith comes out here slow and she catches those feathers, she's going to come out slow again the next time. So Alexis has an important job, because she's going to be running that lure machine, training, guiding, communicating with Dave. We want to have her catch those feathers that moment that she's running her fastest. So we're looking for that body position. You can help keep an eye out for this as well. We're going to be looking for that head down, body low to the ground, ears back. We want to see that tail out parallel to the ground. Tail's really the most important part about the cheetah runs, because that acts as their natural counterbalance. So that's how they're able to stay upright while they're running 60, 70 miles an hour. So it kind of steers them like a rudder on a boat. It's one of my favorite things to watch during the cheetah runs. Watch how she swings that tail around when she turns on a dive on these corners here. So that's one of my favorite things to watch. Now these cheetah runs don't last very long. Cheetahs can really only run for about 30 seconds to a minute before they're completely out of gas. And sometimes they're too tired after they run, they expend so much energy, too tired to even open their mouths and chew their food. So it's a little bit hotter today. We might see Nave get pretty tired quickly, but she's gonna show off some of her speed, grace, and agility. So she'll be coming out of that gate in the far left-hand corner of the habitat, and she's gonna show off her acceleration. So cheetahs can accelerate 0 to 60 in less than 3 seconds. Let that sink in for a second. That's faster than cheetah hunt can go to 60 miles an hour. That's faster than, I'm sure, any of our cars can accelerate to 60 miles an hour as well. So really impressive that a living animal is able to accelerate that quickly. Now, if you've seen a cheetah run at Busch Gardens before, you know that in order to get that gate open, we do a countdown from 5 down to 1. And on 1, we get our eyes and cameras ready at that gate. So our adult cheetahs have learned, when they hear this countdown, that run's about to start. We know that because we see them kind of getting ready behind the gate, pacing back and forth. They know what's about to happen. So I'm going to ask for you all to help out doing a countdown here today. I can see Nave back there. She's ready to run. These feathers look good. Are you guys ready to see Nave run? I think we can do a little bit better than that. You ready to see Nave run? countdown that loud from 5 down to 1, and on 1, get those eyes and cameras ready at that gate. So count that with me here, starting at 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Excellent job by Nate. That's done. She kind of was showing that ambush. We need a little bit there. So cheetahs are ambush predators. They're going to get as close to that prey as possible before they take off running. So we see that same thing here. When that gate went up, she didn't come barreling out of that gate. She kind of stopped that prey for a little bit, and then she turned those jets on to catch the feathers. And she kind of worked a little bit smarter, not harder. So when she made this turn right here, she kind of caught those feathers. So she worked a little bit smarter there rather than running at this top speed. So Nate, we're going to let her know she did a great job by giving her that positive reinforcement training. So that's what we use here at Busch Gardens. All of our sister parks as well, we use positive reinforcement training. Basically, in a nutshell, we let the animals know they did a great job for doing a behavior that we look for. In this case, we want to highlight the run. If they do anything we're not looking for, this is what happens. Absolutely nothing. So they have no change in their environment, no negative consequences or punishment. We just simply wait for opportunities to let them know they did a great job, and I'm waiting on Nate right now. She's kind of enjoying her prized possession there, so she did work really hard to catch that lure. We notice sometimes it's getting pretty difficult to get those cheetahs to leave that lure, so that's the power of that positive reinforcement training in act right now. So even though there's no nutritional value behind those feathers, Nate would rather stay on those feathers rather than getting some meat treats. So we're going to see if Nate wants to come off of those feathers. And then this is that positive reinforcement. So this is our way of letting Nate know she did a great job. And we can let her know that by giving her different types of reinforcement as well. So it doesn't just have to be about the meat. One of Nate's favorite things is chicken broth. So it's just some chicken broth that we heat up to about a coffee hot temperature. And if you put chicken broth in a squirt bottle of the straw, cheetahs absolutely love drinking out of straw. So fun fact for y'all today, you didn't know that cheetahs kind of like drinking out of straw. So that's a funny thing about cheetahs. But yeah. We can also offer her tactile or touch reinforcement. Squat down there, we call it relay. Giving her a rundown. One of the many ways that we can let Nate know she did a great job for coming out here and running. But I definitely want to emphasize to you all that cheetahs do not make good pets. So that's a big problem for them out in Africa. They're being taken out of Africa and put into the pet trade. And just to give you an idea, a cheetah in that pet trade, average lifespan is about 1 year of age. And Nate here is almost 12 years old. So they can live into their mid to late teens at a place like Busch Gardens. Lots of resources going to taking care of these guys that I don't have at home. So we want you to leave it today with more personal connection to the cheetahs, but hopefully not wanting to take one home as a pet. So anything pretty cool? Yeah, excellent. Does anyone have any questions?